Following the murder of three Navajo men in the Farmington and Gallup areas, freelance investigative reporter Carrol Cagle wrote the following series on Navajo Country.
New Mexico, which long has prided itself in being a tricultural state of harmonious diversity, has now been witnessing racial strife. There has been bitterness and there have been confrontations, some of them violent. Three brutal mutilation murders are a part of the story. The setting for the conflict is Navajo country in northwest New Mexico, primarily the reservation border towns of Gallup and Farmington. The leadership of the angry Navajos lies not with the tribal government, but with the Coalition for Navajo Liberation, formed this spring after the three Navajo murders. Those murders, for which three teenaged Anglos were sent to the boys' institution in Springer, provoked a series of Saturday protest marches, the formation of the coalition, and the bringing to the forefront of some long submerged grievances. Coalition leader John Redhouse says the murders should not be regarded as, in his words, the acts of three crazy kids. A longtime Farmington area resident, as are the other coalition leaders, Redhouse says Anglo high school students have long had what he calls a sport, sort of a perverted tradition, of beating up and rolling drunken Indians and bragging about it in the hallways the next day. Drunkenness among Indians also has emerged as a major grievance. The coalition and its allies charge that Anglo merchants are trafficking in misery by peddling cheap booze to Indians, including Indians who already are drunk or underaged. And the coalition leaders say that violence directed against Indians and rampant alcoholism are only part of an entire system of racial discrimination, some subtle, some overt. This racism, they say, includes police brutality, discrimination in restaurants and other public places, and a lack of adequate Indian-oriented services in the schools and the Anglo-operated Indian Center. They say it also involves examples of plain cultural insensitivity, as when the Sheriff's Posse parade included a contingent of mounted cavalrymen from Fort Bliss wearing 19th century trooper uniforms. This provoked a tear gas throwing melee in downtown Farmington because, as Redhouse put it, the cavalry are our Nazis. And the coalition leaders add that the racism includes economic discrimination in many forms. They say it ranges from the housing and job markets to exploitation of Indian jewelry and crafts, and particularly includes full-scale energy industrialization of the reservation. Some Navajos are bitterly angry at the development of coal-burning electricity generating stations, strip mines, electronic plants, and massive coal gasification plants on the reservation. The benefits of these projects, they say, go to Anglo corporations and energy-hungry Anglo cities, while rank-and-file Navajos have been sold out by their own tribal government and by the federal government, two entities supposedly charged with protecting the rights and interests of the Navajo people.
Now what can I do? Say a powerless few with a lump in your throat and a tear in your eye. Can't you see that their poverty's profiting you? My country, 'tis of thy people you're dying.
This is Carrol Cagle on KMYR.